And right now, we have a short pitch from Zoltan Andrassy, the CTO of HeatVentures. Now, Zoltan is an engineer and has been for 6 years. He founded this company together with his wife, and they're working on their dream, which is one, working together, and two, building this innovation, which is a new algorithm for better heat storage. All right, Zoltan is going to tell us how a data center can save energy by storing it. So please help me welcome to the stage Zoltan Andrassy. Thank you.
Thank you. €20 billion per year. That's how much money could be saved with optimal thermal energy storage just in Europe. I'm Zoltan Andrassy, co-founder and CTO of HeatVentures, and I will present HeatTank, our idea how to save energy for data centers. HeatTank is an energy storage solution which not only saves energy, money, and space, but what we care about most, the environment. I don't have a clicker. Okay. So, the first question that everyone asks me, why am I here? I mean, I store stuffs, but it's not even data. It's energy. I promise you that from this presentation, thank you very much. I promise you that from this presentation, it will be clear for you how can we do it and what am I doing here. The next question I always get, why do we need to store energy? The answer is simple, but let me be more specific. Everyone knows that electricity needs to be stored because the production and the consumption is not the same time, and also because of many more reasons. It's quite simple to store it in batteries or pump storages. But what if I tell you that storing thermal energy is much more important? Because of two reasons. The first one is similar. The production and the consumption is not the same time, which means we need a storage. For example, if you have a solar collector system and you would like to use hot water even if the sun is not shining, you will need a storage. But in many cases, you don't have enough space. And this is a huge problem in the industry and office buildings as well. The second reason, that imagine you have a data center. You have electrical devices inside which generate heat all day, all night. You have to cool them. But the problem is that if you see this graph behind me, this shows the efficiency of the cooling system. The problem is that during the day, when the sun is shining and it's 40 degrees outside, the cooling system is not efficient. It means that it costs more money to produce the same amount of cooling energy. The idea is that with the storage, it is possible to generate energy when it has the highest efficiency, and when it's not efficient, we can use the pre-stored energy from our storage. Traditionally, we store heat by changing the temperature of the water in huge water boilers. They have many problems. They are too big, too expensive. Their capacity is limited, and they are not efficient enough. 6 years ago, our story started in the University of Budapest of Technology. We had a dream. We wanted to make a better solution for storing energy. During these 6 years, we investigated all the companies who are already in the market, and we found many, many weaknesses, which we corrected during the years. Instead of water, we use special biomaterials called phase change materials. We melt and solidify the material inside our tank, and by doing this, it is possible to decrease the storage size by almost 90%, save between 20 to 40% energy with a return on investment between 1.5 to 3 years. You can imagine it as a huge ice cube inside our storage. but we don't use ice or water because it melts at 0 degrees. For cooling system, we use materials around 20 degrees and for heating around 50 degrees. HeatVentor's products are patented, low cost, yet customizable to fit unique needs. We have standardized products, I will show you later, but we can make unique products as well in the future thanks to our algorithm, which we developed during the years, thanks to our control, which ensures that the most energy is saved in the system, and thanks to our flexible manufacturers who can make unique products in a mass scale. The heat storage market is massive. In Europe, it exceeds 5 billion euros annually. We offer infinity use cases for renewable energy, heating and cooling systems, and industrial applications as well. At the moment, we are focusing on cooling data centers, telecommunication sites, or Bitcoin miner rigs, as we believe that the most energy could be saved in this part. With the following companies, we are working together to make this dream possible, testing the product, and already started to sell our products to them. Let me show you an example with one of our running projects. Behind me, you can see a telecommunications site. There are servers and electrical equipment inside, which generate heat all day, all night, which means they need to be cooled immediately. They are using standard air conditioning machine to do that. The problem is with that, what I mentioned before, that the efficiency is highly dependent on the outside air temperature. During the day, it's more expensive to cool than during the night. You can see on the graph behind me, showed with yellow. This is the electricity consumption of the cooling system. With our storage, we are able to save energy because of three reasons. Reason number one, we can produce the energy during the night, store it, so for during the day, we don't have to use the air conditioner anymore. You can see the red area shows the invested energy during the night, and you can see that we can save the green area. You can see the difference, so we are definitely saving energy here. Reason number two is we can use free cooling. Free cooling means that we are using the potential cooling energy of the outside night air when the outside air has a lower temperature than the inside. With that, we are able to use free cooling energy. Traditionally, or conventional systems has big problems because the outside air contains moisture and dust, and servers don't really like that. Our system is indirect, so it means that we don't have these kind of problems. The third reason is the combination of the two. So if it's possible during the night, we can store energy by free cooling for free, and during the day, we can use the energy what we stored before, so we don't have to operate the cooling system. By using free cooling is possible, like in the European climate, between 50 to 90% of the year. So it has a big potential to save energy. For this project, 28% of energy was saved because they had a free cooling system already, and the return on investment is 2.4 years. We are here because we offer a solution for data centers, telecommunication sites, and crypto miners. You can see the data of one of our standardized products. And if you are interested in saving energy for data centers or any kind of electrical equipment, you can contact us there. And what is the most important thing? Don't forget, HeatVentor is the cool way to store heat. Thank you.
Zoltan, thank you.
Thanks
a lot. We have a few minutes for questions. Anybody got a question? Okay, I got a question.
Nice.
You didn't mention your team. Mm-hmm. Tell me about your team.
Okay. So the story started 6 years ago in the University of Technology in Budapest. With my co-founder, she is actually my wife now, we started the research in the university. And from this research, we started to do some publications. We got invited to many conferences. We got many scientific prizes. And everyone said, we should continue. We should do a product. We should start a company. And we should spread the word with this technology because it's cool. And we started it. At the moment, we have 4 people. Two of us, co-founders, are engineers. We have a business person who is good in IoT as well. He is an engineer as well. He has good connection in telecommunication companies. And the fourth member responsible for the PR and the marketing.
Thank you. Are there any other questions? Not right now. Okay, thank you so much. Thanks for joining us. Thanks
thank
for
you very
presenting.
Much.
All the best.